Morning, everybody. Coach Chris Specht, the wise guy. Follow me on Instagram. Yesterday was a success, despite me not hitting my goal of finding $2,000 profit. It still was successful. Was able to find $1,300 in profit, you guys. And I'll go through each one individually and give you guys some insight as to how a retail arbitrage business works and how you can work it for yourself. Profitable products that will move really quickly in my Amazon store. So in these next couple stories here, I'm going to talk about what people are asking me, the questions that people are asking me. I'm going to answer those questions right now for you. I take all that inventory, I box it up, and via Amazon actually negotiated really deep discounted prices using UPS, so you can ship your inventory Amazon. Some of the questions I received yesterday was, Coach, what do you do with all that inventory? Do you keep it in your house? Where do you store it? I get this question all the time. Actually, it's probably one of the most common questions, and it's exactly why I do retail arbitrage, and it's exactly why I do Amazon FBA. I do not keep the inventory in my house. I do not keep it in a storage locker. I do not keep it in my basement or my garage. I ship all the inventory that I buy, every single item, I ship it to Amazon's warehouses. Amazon store the inventory for me. So I don't need space in my home. I don't need to have stuff lying everywhere in my home. Amazon Seller Central is the software that sellers like myself use to handle their inventory. Via Seller Central, you can choose a deep discounted shipping option, which allows you to ship all your inventory to fulfillment centers. And that deep discount shipping option is in conjunction with UPS, and Amazon has negotiated ridiculously cheap rates. It's gotta be like 80% cheaper. Every aspect of your business, you just gotta upload the products to your storefront and get the inventory to Amazon. And the best way to do it is via Amazon Seller Central. Then at UPS store. You package your stuff up, you create a shipping plan, and then you ship all your inventory to Amazon. They store it for you. They handle the shipping to your customers. They handle all your returns. They handle... What's going on, Amazon sellers? Coach Chris Specht, the wise guy. Follow me right here on Instagram. Next question that I get a lot that I thought I would give you guys some insight on is the question of, do you need a business license when you start your Amazon business? And the answer to that question is no. You do not need to go and set up a business or get yourself a business license just yet. What you can do is you can set up a personal Amazon selling account or a professional Amazon selling account, and you don't need a business license. You can set that all up under your person. When you need a business license is when you start to put volume of sales together. So the number is $30,000 or $10,000 3 months in a row. Answer it right now for you guys. Part one, their question was, as a new seller, it's my understanding that Amazon has a lot of restrictions on the categories you can sell. And there's, okay, question number three is actually a question I recently got on my YouTube channel from somebody who is interested in being or becoming a new Amazon seller. And it was a two-part question. I'll see if I can answer for you guys right now. A lot of restrictions on the products you can sell. And if I were to join now in Q4, they restrict new sellers in Q4. So a meaty question there. I'll try to answer that. So first let me discuss the restrictions that you have as a new seller. As a new seller, Amazon restricts you based on the type of seller you want to become. So if you just sign up as a free seller, like you're not paying a monthly subscription rate, and you're just doing selling under your account, there is a limit to the categories you can sell in and the products that you can sell. You're pretty much setting yourself up as an entry-level seller.
So you do not gain, or you do not have access to all the categories that you would, say, if you signed up as a professional seller. Whereas if you signed up as a professional seller, you would be paying Amazon $30 a month. Amazon then would give you even more access to more categories and products that you can sell on Amazon. But as a personal seller, you do have restrictions, but you still have hundreds of products to sell, if not thousands. Talk about the restrictions of the fourth quarter seller. The fourth quarter seller is the seller who only sells during the fourth quarter on Amazon. So for the months of October, November, and December. Amazon attracts a lot of sellers who just want to sell during the prime period, where Amazon often does three times the sales. Those are, I call, bandwagoners, where they jump on and then jump off when sales are done. Okay, Amazon will restrict you in the fourth quarter as a new seller. Now, they're going to put two rules in place. First rule is, if you do FBA or fulfillment by merchant, then you will not have restrictions. You can apply, you will gain access, but you have to do fulfillment by Amazon. Number two, your metrics as a seller must be really good. You cannot have claims against you. You cannot have bad reviews against you that give you strikes, that lower your sell. Now, so step one, go to Amazon Seller Central and register a professional account. Professional will allow you to sell in more categories and more products, and it'll give you more back-end analytics and metrics. Step two, ship your inventory to Amazon. You have to do fulfillment by Amazon so that you do not have those restrictions. And step three, the most important, if you want to sign up as a professional Amazon seller in the fourth quarter and reap the benefits of three times the sales volume, here's three easy steps that I would recommend you do right now. Important step is go and join Coach Chris Beck's Amazon Selling Hustle Mentorship course. You get full access to our group and full access.